हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आवर मॉरल साइंस क्लास। टुडे वी विल लर्न यूनिट 7, इट्स फॉर अस। ओके, दिस चैप्टर इज अ स्टोरी ऑफ अरुणा एंड हर ब्रदर हर्ष, हु हैड गॉन टू विजिट देयर अंकल राज इन दिल्ली ड्यूरिंग द समर हॉलीडेज। दिस स्टोरी टीचेज अस अ लेसन टू प्रोटेक्ट एंड रेस्पेक्ट public property. Before starting this chapter, we should know what are private property and public property. Okay? Private property. Private property is property owned by individual or a group of individuals. For example, furniture, car, house, land and jewelry, because they are owned by single individual or group of individuals. The owner of a private property can exchange, sell or even destroy his property. Public property. Public property is property owned by the government. Such property is meant for the welfare of the people. It is available for public use. All people of the country have equal right to use it. Public bus, trains, post office, roads, public schools and colleges, government hospitals are all public properties. Since public property is owned by the government can sell, exchange or destroy it. Okay? Now, let's start the chapter. One day, Aruna and Harsh with their uncle went to Tughlaq Bagh Fort, which was built by Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq, a Sultan of Delhi. A few tourists also came to see the fort. Here they saw some boys are scribbling on the wall of the fort, and one of the tourists stopped them. The boys ran away, but Aruna and Harsh felt ashamed. The tourist told Uncle Raj that they respect public property and they are proud of their monuments. On the way back from the fort, they visited the Indian Museum, which is the biggest museum in India, and they saw various statues and works of art there. In the museum, some parents were busy in laughing, chatting and sharing jokes, and their children touching the statues. Then an elderly foreign tourist told the parents that don't allow your children to touch the statues. They are very valuable and may get damaged. Aruna and Harsh again felt ashamed. They learnt an important lesson that tourists expect us to respect public property. Through this chapter, we conclude that we keep our homes clean and take care of our personal belongings, like books, games, clothes, etc. But we dirty public places and property, like railway stations, parks and gardens, trains and buses, roads and pavement, etc. Historical monuments and heritage sites are also public property, like Taj Mahal, Qutub Minar, Red Fort, Golden Temple, Ellora Caves, etc. In fact, any harm done to this is regarded as a criminal offense and draws severe punishment. In these pictures, like badly littered park, badly scribbled historical monument, running water tap, All these are actions of irresponsible citizens who spoil public property. Habit of spitting anywhere and at any time is a very bad habit. We throw toffees and other food wrappers and papers from the windows of moving vehicles. Some miscreants have the habit of tearing the seats in trains and buses. We think public property is government property. No, public property is our property. We are the public. Your parents pay taxes. The government uses this money to run trains and buses, build and maintain roads, bridges, parks, etc. And when we destroy any public property, we are destroying our own property. We are wasting our own money. Some people love to write their names, the date of their visit, etc. on these heritage structures. Such actions only damages these priceless monuments. Such acts are punishable by law. If you ever see anybody damaging a heritage structure, do stop him or her. If they don't listen, report it to the security personnel present on the premises. When we respect public property, it shows how much we love our country. If we understand their value and take good care of them, we can be proud citizens of India. At last, the lesson of this chapter is we should protect and respect public property. Today I have explained this chapter. In next video, we will do its exercise work. And your homework will be read, think a little. Thank you. Have a nice day.